whatever. It's purely like glory. There's no money involved. There's no, but for the community, for us as a group, as a group of friends, getting together and being able to reach out that far, and now we're on a mission.
Cosmos Copa really transcends just soccer. It mobilizes those ethnic groups in New York that, even though they've been here many, many years, their hearts, still part of them, belong to the country they came from. And Cosmos Copa pulls it all together under one roof. So you have the best of both worlds. It's living, playing, competing in New York City, but it embraces the ethnic diversity and the culture that all of these players and teams and fans have close to their heart.
You know, it's not the professional World Cup, but it's an amateur World Cup, since it's a World Cup. Like, you have to take it seriously, and we do, and we are very proud and honored to play this final, you know. It's our World Cup, and you know, it's at the same level than the others.
36 teams, 36 different communities, but all with one singular goal: to be crowned the best in New York. Every summer, approximately 800 amateur and semi-professional players wear their nation's colors to represent their country in the Cosmos Copa.
Copa is very important for not just the Irish community, I think for every community that loves soccer or football, call it what you want. It gives young men the opportunity to wear their national jersey in the biggest, greatest city in the world. And when you're associated with a cup and it's called Copa, Cosmos, once that is in it, I mean, it tells you how important it is. And these young lads, they would never get this chance in Ireland, but they get a chance here.
We got very good two games ahead of us, very important games.
We won the first one, 1-0.
So we're just relaxing right now, getting ready, you know. We need a
30 minutes away from the second game. We need a victory, a big game.
This is the keeper right here.
Yeah, we need that second game. We are playing against Paraguay. We need to beat them like, beating like from, like 3-0 or 4-0. Yeah, we are now relaxed. We got our muscle up back. Everything is back in position. We gotta do what we do.
Representing our country.
Okay.
Representing our country. Gambia, Senegal.
Viva Bolivia!
This tournament is a melting pot, not just for local New York legends and aspiring young players, but also for former and current professionals who meet every year in New York. The 2013 edition saw Marseille defender Rod Fanny suit up for France, while Spain fielded former La Liga star Raul Tabudo and Mikel Alonso. Italy would benefit from the presence of veteran Serie B striker Alessandro Nocelli, who would later sign a contract with the New York Cosmos.
Cosmos Coppa è una coppa importantissima organizzata sempre dai Cosmos qui a New York ed è sentitissima. Ho tanti amici italiani che ci giocano, ho giocato le qualificazioni anch'io quest'anno per l'Italia ovviamente ed è sentitissima, ci sono molte persone a vedere, ne parlano mesi prima, è veramente un evento importante per la città di New York e per tutte le nazioni di New York. È una cosa bellissima perché insomma è organizzata bene, è sentita ed è fatta bene, insomma, per quelli che vogliono, fra virgolette, sentirsi importanti in una competizione importante che può essere come la Cosmos Copa, è una cosa bellissima.
It's a big deal, starting with 16, it's like 38. Africa, Latin America, I mean obviously whatever people coming from, like in Europe, it is a big deal. I think it's a very smart project that they built 5 years back, and I mean, yeah, it means a lot to us as a community, I told you. it's actually good to bring all those communities together. It's that one occasion a year when we all get together, get some friendly game, still remain friendly but very competitive. And if you played soccer once in a life, whether it's semi-professional, professional, amateur, you're here to win, you're here to represent your team, whether it's a country, a city, and being in New York added a little bit more, add up to the whole, you know, glory of that tournament. And yeah, I mean, I purely agree with him, and I hope actually it could take even more, it could be bigger than that.
It's a free event, you know, and you know, it doesn't get any better than that. It's a beautiful thing, you know, especially, and we're actually fasting, a Muslim, you know, I'm fasting, but I came in here especially to see this final, because I kept asking my son, I said, you know what, I want to go, all of us are actually from Afghanistan, and we're, you know, fasting, and some of the Senegalese guys, I was talking to them, they're fasting too. But it's a beautiful thing. At the same time, they have a final, and they came in here with fasting and also playing soccer. It's not an easy thing to do, but for the love of the game, they're here and they're presenting their country.
Cosmo Copa, when they approached us 4 years ago, 5 years ago, it was a soccer tournament that united different ethnic background or culture here in New York City. And we like the idea of that, you know, to play and represent your country with nationals that live in New York City as well, that have a common story, that all decided to come to America to try something else. So that was a little bit, for me, the concept, and I liked it. It was first, you know, for me, being back into something I love, soccer, football, and playing for my country. And even if it's in New York, it was something that I was proud of and flattered to be approached and excited about doing.
My life is soccer, and I have played and as a broadcaster, been all over the world. Broadcast the Olympics, the World Cup, every continent. And when you talk about the world's most international city, I believe it's New York City. So the World Cup, this is the mini World Cup. It's the World Cup for New York. And New York is the best city to have it.
New York City is one of the world's greatest soccer cities, and this tournament brings together some of the best men's players in North America while also celebrating the city's rich cultural diversity and promoting local soccer talent. New York's unique demographics, a large and ethnically diverse metropolis as befits a city with its long history of immigration, makes it one of the few cities in the world capable of hosting such a cosmopolitan tournament.
More important thing for me is that people who didn't know before can meet and play together, because they come maybe from all states in America, for North Carolina, Chicago, they come from Rhode Island, from Boston too, you know, and it's a meeting point for us first.
The level of the tournament is very high, you know, it's very competitive. So in order to be ready to compete, we made a lot of effort and sacrifice. For example, we practiced a lot, more than 30 times during the last 2 months. We made like 10 friendly games, and I think we are happy to be in the final, because it was a lot of time, effort, and the players, they deserve to be here. You know, we have very good players, and some of them, they were very close to a professional career. So this final is kind of a showcase of their talent, their skill, and I'm very, very happy for them.
I think the level of Copa is much greater than anything else I've seen, and maybe I'm a little biased because I'm president of the Irish team, but it's one of the things that has always concerned me in the United States, is the fact that you can go to a place like Van Cortlandt Park, you can go to Flushing Meadows, or you can go to some of the parks in Brooklyn, and you see all these great young players, and you never hear from them again because of the way the scouting system is done here, and these lads never get a chance. I think Copa really shows that there is so much good talent in the city.
I feel like I said earlier, I feel like I'm at home right now, because First of all, we're just gonna speak like Senegalese the entire 90 minutes, you know, like making jokes, making fun. Like, it's really nice, you know, to be representing your own country. Everybody that you see in here, we all know each other for years now, you know, we hang out together, you know, we eat together, we party together, so we're just like a group of friends. We're just friends, teammates, and everything. I just see it as a good tournament, you know, that I'm looking forward to play it every year, and I'm just very happy to be here. I mean, soccer is the reason why I came to the United States. Like, I came here for the love of soccer, you know. I came to play in colleges, and now that I'm done with college, so I'm just looking to play for a club.
When one thinks of the Cosmos, the legendary Brazilian Pelé instantly comes to mind. The greatest soccer player of all time played for the Cosmos for three seasons between 1975 and 1977 and changed the face of soccer in the U.S. Today, he is the club's honorary president, and along with fellow Brazil and Cosmos legend Carlos Alberto, Pelé has made various appearances to support Cosmos Copa and recognize the importance of the tournament's grassroots outreach.
Pelé is really a great striker. He's one of the best strikers that ever lived in the world. So, you know, I mean, he's just a pioneer of soccer. So we all love Pelé, and everybody who loves soccer should know Pelé, definitely. If you don't love Pelé, you don't love soccer.
Pelé is for soccer players, the best player ever, you know?
But yeah, Pelé means a lot growing up, watching his, you know, whatever he accomplished, whatever his court, and it meant so much. Brazil will be and will always remain one of the ultimate nationality when it comes to soccer. And obviously him being a part of Cosmos back in the days means a lot to us. And yeah, believe that it's a legend. He's a legend.
Just his name, I mean, everybody, even my son today, he was telling me Pelé is coming. I didn't even know that. I mean, his name is so huge, you understand? Just because of him, people will go anywhere just to follow the event or the Cosmo, you know, and it's huge. It's, you know, it's beautiful. Just his name being attached to the Cosmo, you understand? I mean, people is going to 100% is going to support them and go whatever the Cosmo going to be.
I think he was a fantastic player at this time. He was an icon. He was more than just a soccer player as well. He represented a lot more. And I think it's incredible for the image of the Cosmo that guys like him now are behind the image of the club and represent it. It's fantastic.
The whole world today knows, I want to say to everyone, to the whole world, New York Cosmo, come back. We are here with the new generation. Make a noise, make a noise. Make a noise.
I thank God because that time I was a champion of the world from Brazil. 73 I was champion with Santos. I was the best scorer in the league in Brazil. Then I had a lot of proposals to play in Europe, you know, to play in Japan, to play in Mexico. But I decided to come to play in Cosmos because I think it was important to start with the football soccer here. We are here for that, you know. I want to ask to all the people who support us, you know, some years ago, to come back to support the New York Cosmos now because we are here again.
É gol do Cosmos! New York Cosmos!
LA!
Today, every place in the world where you go, the people, they say, Pelé, when New York Cosmos come back? Sometimes I got a little, you know, upset because I said, listen, I played 25 years in Santos. Nobody asked for my team in Santos. I am proud of that because we made the football soccer, and I'd say it well known. And then now we are here to come back to ask to your help because New York is back.
On August 3rd, 2013, the New York Cosmos returned to professional American soccer with a sellout win at Hofstra University Schuylkill Stadium in their NASL fall season opener. It had been nearly 30 years since the Cosmos had played in a professional league, yet the foundation for the team's return had already been laid with its involvement with Cosmos Copa, a tournament that allowed the club to keep grounded in the local New York community while keeping the team's name alive. Since 2009, Cosmos Copa has grown at a remarkable rate, from 16 teams in its founding year to over 30 teams in five summers. It has become arguably the most prominent amateur adult soccer tournament in the United States.
I think the way Cosmos Copa helps to grow soccer in New York is that it's far-reaching in terms of its tentacles. You can market or sell a pro team to a certain audience, or an under 10 team to a certain audience. But at a certain level, Cosmos Copa reaches out to everybody. It reaches into the heart and soul of the ethnic communities that are represented at Cosmos Copa.
Well, if you go to 42nd Street and Times Square, it's considered to be the melting pot of the world. So if you don't think that New York is the best place for a cup like this, I don't know where else would. There is no place measures up to it. I mean, you have every conceivable nationality in the world is here, and you can see the Copa keeps growing. There are more nations who want to compete in it. I would think that the goal is to unearth some really good young stars who would never get an opportunity because of the way the scouting is done. This is an opportunity to put young players in the shop window and perhaps uncover a couple that maybe will go on to play with the Cosmos.
We have pro soccer in New York. We have amateur soccer. We have high school soccer. We have youth soccer. But this is a level of soccer that's very competitive. It's very nationalistic, and there's a great deal of pride involved.
Soccer is growing, and I'm convinced that in the next 20 years, the US team will be able to compete with the best team in the World Cup and maybe win the World Cup.
I think, you know, whether it's a final or any game, if you're very competitive, whether you play a friendly game or you play a competitive game like today, you want to win always, every time you step on the field. I think that's the attitude of guys in my team, and I'm sure the same for the other players. So yes, it's very important that we win this game. Because I think we have a good team. We've done, a very good last 2.5 months of training, friendly games, competition so far. I think we have a tremendous game. I know we're playing a very, very good game, Senegal. They're very disciplined, they're very athletic. I know it's going to be a very difficult game, but I think I've got great guys, very skillful, smart. I think we have a very good chance.
No, not so much. We've hung out with the guys last night. We've had a good meal together, very good preparation. Good pre-game meal today, everybody's prepared, so no, there's no reason. If we play seriously, if we do what we have to do and play the way we've been playing lately, there's nothing can happen to us. Honestly, I have a good feeling. We've had some really good games all the way throughout the tournament, but very important thing is that we've been growing up, we've been raising our level every single stage.
Soccer's been my whole life, you know. I played soccer my whole life, and I went to school here, played soccer. And I'm into soccer again, coaching, so it's like, that's what I do, like almost 24/7. You know, we don't have baseball or like football, so soccer is number one in our country, yeah.
It's a big deal.
Yeah, it's a big deal, yeah, big deal. I don't see there's a tournament like this in the whole US, so this is big. Being into the final, you know, being into it first, that's huge. If we win it, it's gonna be big, all right? They wanna win it, and be like Senegal won it, like I said. It's gonna be huge.
I would say the most difficult game was the first one, because when you play Albania in the first game, Albania won this tournament in 2009, so it's a good team. And when you start a tournament, you have to win the first game, otherwise you are in a in a difficult path, you know. So it was difficult because everybody was stressed. Everybody knows the importance of this game. And we didn't play well, but we beat them. It was the most important thing. And then you build confidence. And we build confidence games by games. In terms of level, the most difficult game was the semi-final against Greece, because it was a very, very strong team with top players. But we were stronger and we had a lot of opportunities. We scored two, but we should have scored maybe three or four, and it was our best game of the tournament.
To be honest with you, I think the hardest part was more of the qualification and the stage group, just because in the last few years we did fail at that stage, and it was insanely frustrating in regards of whatever efforts and compromise we made. And I do believe, I mean, maybe some other guy will tell you, but quarterfinals and semifinals look pretty easy to us just because we did reach out to that level. And as I told you, we were on a mission. So now we're here to win, and we have the perfect confidence that we can do it, and we're gonna do it. We've been training, I would say, 3 to 4 times a week. That takes a lot of time on our professional schedule, personal lives. So we definitely had to adjust. Some of us, even, I mean, 95% of us are based out of New York, but some even came from outside the country to be here, to represent the country. So it's a lot of sacrifice for everyone, but put all together, it means a lot and makes perfect sense, especially now we're in the final, so.
Not really. I mean, I respect the French team. You know, they make it to the final, so you have to respect them. You know, playing them a couple times. There's no pressure, you know. It's a soccer game. It's a final. We want to win, of course, but, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's going to be a soccer game, so no high pressure now.
You remember Senegal in Korea in Japan, you know, against France, like today. Oh, against Brazil. Yes, we have the same culture. We are speaking French, you know. I speak French, and all these guys have been to school in French, you know. And we share this culture, and we share this friendship with France.
72 matches, a month-long journey to reach the final. Each team faced its own challenges in making its way past the qualifying rounds. Favorite teams such as 2012 champion Haiti and Spain, bolstered by former La Liga stars, surprisingly failed to reach the round of 16.
You know, the final is, I think, the easiest game of the tournament. Since we go that far, now let's play, let's have fun, and let's win the trophy, you know.
France is a team that has been impressive throughout this tournament. And not only throughout the tournament, but from the qualification. And they remind us of us 2 years ago, because we were the team that went through qualification, you know, and then did well. So I guess we have to also give them the same respect, but also know that, you know, we have a reputation, and reputation is what people think of you.
The final would see an unexpected matchup between stalwart Senegal and upstart France. The final was a close affair, with neither team able to assert their dominance. A tense 120-minute stalemate was decided by the drama of a penalty shootout. At the end, there were tears of despair for Senegal and joy for Les Bleus, who for the first time in the history of the tournament lifted the Cosmos Copa.